A very common use case for many businesses is onboarding your clients to some sort of process. When you sign a new client, you need a way to make sure that you get all of the different things from that client that you need in order to do your job. There's usually some sort of onboarding process, and having an app to help your clients navigate this process is going to set you above the competition. In this video, I'm going to be breaking down for you how you can create your own custom onboarding application without any code whatsoever. If learning more about this is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of no-code software. No-code software is that software that allows you to build amazing things, deploy applications without needing to know any code whatsoever. And in this video, I'm going to be focusing on one of my favorite tools called Softr. Softr allows us to build an interface or a portal, publish it live on the web, and then our users can access that and actually review, edit, delete the data that we want them to have access to. It's a really amazing tool, and we're going to be using a template called the Client Onboarding Template. But before we get into it, I want to invite you to follow along with me. If you are new to Softr in general, if you've never signed up before, they have given us a coupon that you can use to get 1 month free of their pro plan. It's going to save you over $100 if you use this coupon. So follow the instructions that you see on your screen and go ahead and get access to your discount code. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of the video. This is all about diving into the client onboarding template. Now, we're going to break this into three major chunks. Chunk one, section one, is going to be a little tour of what the template looks like in a live version of the app. Then we're going to look at how you can install this template into your own workspace in Softr, take ownership of your own data, scrub the data, and get set up. And then thirdly, we're going to talk about how you can customize this template. Maybe you've got your own unique process that you want to make changes around, so you can make changes, branding changes, color changes to the template. So let's go ahead and dive in. Here we are on the client onboarding portal template page. I will share this with the video. You can go ahead and click and just access this directly. Now, rather than going right into using the template, we're going to preview the template. In another tab, it's going to open up an actual version of the template. This is a live, version that we can actually dive into and play around with. You can see that we can just explore the template as two types of users, and this is an important takeaway. There's a version that our clients will see when they log in, and then there's another version that our teammates will see, the managers of our team, the internal component of this. So let's first impersonate a client. We'll click here, and we'll log in as Mike, the fake client that will have access to this onboarding portal. So Mike logs in, and this is what they see. He sees a little thing that says, "Welcome back, Mike. Upcoming tasks." This task is called D. It's just an example. Of course, we can view the task. It's going to open up in a new page. This is the task that Mike has to complete. You can see that it's got some tags to it. If there are related files, they'll show up. All of this information is right here. And of course, Mike can also view the resource. So he can dive in, take a look at the related resource, and here's more information about this. There's also the ability for Mike to comment directly in the app. So this allows you to have consolidated communication. Your team can see these comments, can respond, and make sure that Mike moves through the process to get onboarded appropriately. This all lived, of course, we got here from the dashboard. So on the left-hand side, you see we have the dashboard, tasks, and resources. We can also drill into Mike's tasks here. So by flipping into my tasks, again, these are the tasks that are still outstanding that show up on Mike's dashboard, but we can also review the completed tasks, all of these tasks right here. So how does all this data come into existence? Well, this all is driven from data that lives in our data source. So for us, that could be Airtable, but it doesn't have to be. We can use any number of different data sources that integrate directly with Softr. Think about Softr as being that front end layer, how people get access, limited access to the data. And then on the other end, we have the data source itself. And in this case, we're going to use Airtable as our back end. So this is what the client sees, but we can log out as Mike. Let's sign out of this. We're going to go back here, and now let's log in as Susie. What does Susie see and experience in here? And so you can see that Susie's dashboard, her app experience is a little different. These are the clients that are assigned to Susie. You can see the active clients, and that was Mike right there that we were just impersonating. We can create new clients with a little form, add a profile photo, add a name, an email, decide who's going to be the manager who's helping them onboard. In this case, we only have Susie. And then we can also start assigning tasks, relating tasks to this new client's account. So as you can see, we have different experiences inside of the application. And again, this is all a template, and we can easily copy this template and take ownership of a version of it. And then we can make updates and changes. So let's go into part two now and take a look at how we would get this template working in our own space. We're here on the template page. We can click on Use Template. Alternatively, we can go back to the first template page that we started on and click Use Template from here. It's going to ask us to sign in to Softr if we're not already signed in. There we go. Got us signed in, and we can just go right into using the template. So from here, we have to sync up our data source. Now, again, in our example, we're going to be using Airtable. So I'll make a selection to bring Airtable in here, and we will continue from here. Now, we don't yet have a database in Airtable to store the different components, the different elements that we need in the template. So we have to copy the Airtable base, and Softr makes this so easy. They've already built the backend data schema, and all we have to do is copy it into Airtable. So by selecting copy base, we're now opening a new tab for Airtable. We're choosing where we want to save this database. In this case, I'm going to bring it into my workspace called Gap Consulting, and I'm going to add the base. So just that easily, we're able to copy that database from Softr. It's an Airtable database that Softr provided, but we've now copied a version of it into our Airtable account. Now, it's recommended that you're on a paid Airtable account. Of course, you can try it on the free account, but the free Airtable account is somewhat limited. You'll very likely need to upgrade at some point if you're storing any real amount of data. So here we are, we've got a table for users. And as you can see, here's Susie and Mike, the folks that we were impersonating not too long ago. We also have our tasks. We have a table for comments. This is where we're storing all the comments back and forth that you saw. We have a table for resources. This is how we onboard people and share various resources with them. And lastly, we have a table for feedback. And this way our users can submit feedback if they get stuck, if they have any trouble, or any recommendations they'd like to make. So again, this is where all the data lives. You can add additional layers to your database, but this is what we need at a minimum to get going with the template. Now we're gonna go ahead and flip back into Softr. And in doing so, we see that our app is now connected. Now, if you have any trouble with this, you might have to go into your integration and ensure that you've shared access with your actual new database that you created in Airtable. It's pretty simple to do in Airtable. If I'm back here, I simply click on my profile and I go down to my integrations and I find it. I find the integration where I'm talking to Softr and making sure that I've given it the right level of permissions. Now that we're back in Softr, we can actually build the application, and this is the front end component. So we have the back end in Airtable, and now the front end in Softr, and it's that easy. This is now the template that we have created. You can review the various pages. These all came with the template, and the user's information here is connected to the user's table that we created in Airtable. So that's where it's bringing in that information. The three different emails here, the three different users are coming from Airtable. So when you're ready to go live with your actual solution, what you'll do is go back into Airtable and clear out the example data. This is just sample stuff, right? We're going to delete all of this information, and then you can add in your own users, your own clients, and your own managers. You see here the user role in Airtable. This is what determines what experience a user receives when they log into the app. Are they a manager? Are they a client? It's all driven right here. Now for the third part of the video, let's go back into Softr and talk about how we can make changes. So again, I'm flipping back into Softr, clicking on pages. These are the pages that we currently have. Each page is comprised of multiple blocks. So if I look at the dashboard page, these are the blocks that we're going to see. Welcome back, and then it knows who's logged in, so it'll call them out by name. There's an area here to submit feedback. I've got a vision of upcoming tasks. All of these different blocks I can click into, select the block, and make changes over here on the right-hand side. I can change what the block sees, what it shows. I can change how we filter, how we sort, etc. I can also add additional blocks just by hovering over here and clicking in. I can add not only blocks, but also containers. Maybe I need to add columns here. And within these different columns, we're going to bring in different elements. I can do that just like this, bring in things like bar charts, bring in things like static data. Maybe I just want a call to action, for example, to pop in right here. So as you can see, I have a lot of customization options when it comes to deploying my own application. I don't have to stick with the template, although if you're new to this tool, it's a great place to start. Now, once I'm ready to go live, I go in the upper right-hand corner and I publish my app. When I do this, I'm going to get a subdomain for this. You can update this subdomain and actually put it on a URL of your choosing. But by default, Softr is going to assign us a random subdomain, and then we can just share that subdomain with our end users, and they will be able to log into a live version of our app and start playing around. I know we went pretty quickly in this video, so any questions you have, be sure to drop them below or swing by our website. And I also want to encourage you to try out our free automation training. If you are new to no-code in general, you're going to love this training. It's going to teach you how to start saving time and automating your repetitive tasks without any code. I'll give you that training if you sign up at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. That's it for this video. Thanks a lot for watching. Give us a thumbs up and subscribe. But most importantly, keep on building.